3-speed ECM for Stealth Pro 4.8 and up model. This wiring video will show you how to wire a Stealth Pro 4.8 and up model. For this installation, you will need the following items: a Phillips and flat blade screwdriver, wire cutters, wire strippers, 2-wire Romex, 3-wire Romex, black electrical tape, a double 3-way switch, and an 8-hour timer. Important: wiring diagrams are for examples only. Wiring should be done by a licensed electrician following local building and electrical codes and/or NEC guidelines. If you are installing this fan unit in new construction, please note that if use of arc fault breakers are 100% implemented in the home, or if the fan is being installed in a wet area such as a bathroom, you may be required to wire a dedicated circuit for the fan. Note that the fan came pre-wired to a power cord for testing purposes before installation. If you would like to hardwire the fan, or if it is required by the local building codes, please follow the wiring instructions in this video. Let's begin at the motorhead and remove the power cord from the fan. First, remove the junction box cover. With the junction box cover removed, remove each wire nut and separate the wires. Remove the 2 Romex connectors that were included inside the junction box. Remove the ground wire of the power cord by unscrewing the ground screw. Remove the power cord by removing the power cord strain relief connector in the back of the junction box. If the connector is difficult to remove, you may need to use a pair of pliers. Knock out one of the other holes in the junction box. Install the included Romex connectors in the 2 open junction box holes. Push the 2-wire Romex from the power source through the Romex connector on the back of the junction box. Push the 2-wire Romex from the timer and the 2-wire Romex from the switch through the Romex connector on the right of the junction box. Cut the sheathing off of each of the Romex wires. Reinstall the ground screw and the motor ground wire in the junction box. Using wire cutters, cut the ground wire in half. This will allow you to ground the motor and wall switches to the junction box in the fan. Now strip both sides of the green ground wire. Cut the bare copper wires to the appropriate length. Use Using a wire nut, tie the two ground wires together with the bare copper wires. Grab the white wire from the power source Romex and the white wire from the timer Romex and cut them to the appropriate length and strip them. Using a wire nut, tie the white wires from the power source Romex and timer Romex to the white wire from the motor. Grab the black wire from the power source Romex and the black wire from the timer Romex and cut them to the appropriate length and strip them. Using a wire nut, tie the black wires from the power source Romex and timer Romex to the black striped wire from the motor. Strip the black wire from the switch Romex. Using a wire nut, tie the black wire from the switch Romex to the blue wire from the motor. Using black electrical tape, tape the white wire from the switch Romex. We are taping this wire to indicate that the white wire is carrying power. Strip the taped white wire from the switch Romex. Using a wire nut, tie the taped white wire from the switch Romex to the yellow wire from the motor. Strip the red wire from the switch Romex. Using a wire nut, tie the red wire from the switch Romex to the red wire from the motor. Make sure all wire nuts are tight and secure. Once complete, reinstall the junction box cover. Now, let's move to the wall switch. First, grab a piece of black wire and strip both sides. Using the pliers, create a loop on both sides. Attach one end of the black wire to the top gold screw on the right side of the switch. Attach the other end of the black wire to the bottom black screw on the left side of the switch. Using the pliers, break off the tab on the left side of the switch. After running the 2-wire timer Romex and the 3-wire switch Romex from the fan head into the 2-gang wall box, cut the sheathing off of the Romex. Cut the bare copper ground wires to the appropriate length. Cut a small piece of bare copper wire and using a wire nut, tie the green ground wire from the timer to the three bare copper wires. Cut the white wire from the timer Romex to the appropriate length and strip the wire. Using a wire nut, tie the white wire from the timer to the white wire from the timer Romex together. Cut the black wire from the timer Romex to the appropriate length and strip the wire. Using a wire nut, tie the black wire from the timer to the black wire from the timer Romex. Make sure all wire nuts are tight and secure. Carefully push the wires into the wall box and install the timer using included mounting screws. Using black electrical tape, tape the white wire from the switch Romex. This taped white wire will be used for medium speed. Grab the black, red, and taped white wire from the switch Romex and cut them to the appropriate length. Using the pliers, create a loop on the remaining bare copper ground wire. Attach the bare copper wire to the green screw on the switch and securely tighten the screw. Strip the red wire from the timer and connect it to the top left black screw on the switch. Strip the remaining wires from the switch Romex. Using the pliers, create a loop on the remaining wires. Attach the black wire to the second gold screw on the right of the switch. Attach the taped white wire to the third gold screw on the right of the switch. Attach the red wire to the last gold screw on the right of the switch. Now that the wiring is complete, carefully push the wires into the wall box and install the switch with the attached mounting screws. Using the included wall plate screws, install the QuietCool wall plate. Now that the install is complete, turn the power on at the electrical panel. Operating the timer is very simple. Pressing the button at the front of the timer will set the fan to 1 hour. Pressing the button a second time will move to 2 hours. Pressing the button a third time will move to 4 hours. Pressing the button a fourth time will move to 8 hours. holding the button will put the fan into an indefinite hold and the fan will run until you turn it off. With the top switch in the left position, the bottom switch will be active. With the bottom switch in the left position, the fan will be on medium speed. With the bottom switch in the right position, the fan will be on low speed. With the top switch in the right position, the fan will be on high speed, and the bottom switch will be inactive. Remember, you must select a timer setting to activate the switch. To turn off the fan in any setting, simply cycle through the time settings until the timer lights turn off.